The Anacrusis. Is it worth a buy? Let's read the words on Steam. The Anacrusis is a four-player cooperative first-person shooter set aboard a massive starship stranded at the edge of explored space. Team up with your friends in an infinitely replayable fight against alien hordes to unlock perks, weapons, and new ways to play that you can share with your team. First up, guys, we'll have a quick look at the graphicals in this early access game. It's early access at the moment. There's just a tiny few options. I mean, they've got the main things here, I guess. You've got a FOV slider, which is important in a first-person shooter, and you've got a few things that you can tweak just to get the game running fine. I'm running on a 2080 here, no problems whatsoever. It runs quite slick, haven't had any crashes. It seems quite well optimized from what I've seen. My girlfriend's running it on a 1070. She had no problems either. So actually, I did have one crash. At the end of one of the levels. I had to reboot it. So the game sucks. There you go. Now, one crash is fine. I mean, we played it pretty much all night. So yeah. Now, this is your Left 4 Deads, your Back 4 Bloods. That's what this game is. It's on that same kind of ilk as them. It's set aboard a very, very psychedelic kind of spaceship, and the characters in the game, awful that they are like 70s kind of hip guys, you know. Just the whole, I don't get it. I don't understand why this era was chosen. Why, I just don't get it at all. It just doesn't work for me one little bit. I think the characters are just dreadful. I mean, one of them looks the most miserable person on the planet. Her eyes are dead. She looks like she's ready to just kill herself. It's just hilarious. Just so bad. And you know what? You get to know nothing about the characters. There's no like reason why they're all together. It's not like it is in Left 4 Dead where it all makes sense. In this, you're just thrown together with like three other people. You have no idea anything about them. And there's no chemistry going on. It's just full of absolutely awfully written garbage, you know, the kind of shit that you would expect in a Marvel movie. Now, in fact, it's way worse than the shit you get in a Marvel movie. Just people, I mean, you're on a spaceship surrounded by hundreds and hundreds of monsters and you're just cracking jokes all the time. I mean, what the fuck, man? It's bullshit, absolute garbage. The maps themselves are rubbish as well, absolutely boring maps. They're just dead. The whole game is just like a dead, soulless experience for me. It just didn't really do anything for me at all. You've got to compare this to Left 4 Dead. You've got to compare it to Back 4 Blood. And both of them games have a really good atmosphere about them. This, it just has no atmosphere at all. The enemies, for example, look like ordinary people with Halloween masks on. They don't act or even look like any kind of threatening monster. They literally look like you, humans running around with masks on. One of the guys I was playing with said they're like the head, you know, that, remember the head crabs in Half-Life when they would jump on the scientists or whoever it was and transform them into zombies? You would see the state of them with that head crab on. You'd see the blood on them. They would shamble around. It was convincing. It didn't look like a guy with a head crab stuck on his head. They looked like some kind of evolved being. These, they just run around. Look, they literally look like you've gone to a cheap mask shop, bought a stupid latex mask, put it on your head, and you run around like a prick. While I'm talking about the monsters, let's talk about the different types of infected, the special ones. You have this guy who spawns balls, and the balls come at you. It's called a spawner, and he spawns these balls, and the balls just come running and attacking you. And they turn into what look like plants when they get in range and start firing at you. Terrible. Just not good at all. You have brutes, which are these big, strong things, which are like tanky. They're so fast. Very hard to shoot when you're on a side angle to them. If they're coming straight at you, you have to get out of the way quick because they'll knock you to tomorrow. They will really do damage. I quite enjoy them. They're probably the best of the enemies. Then you've got a flasher, who the idea is he tries to make it hard for you to see by brightening. He blinds you in real life, pretty much. This monster needs absolutely tweaking because he literally, you need sunglasses on when you're playing this when you come across a flasher. It's just, awful. I mean, you know when you get flashbanged in a game and the whole screen goes white? That's perfect. We've had that for years. Now, for some reason, the developers think, no, let's blind the c**ts in real life. It's just nuts. And then you've got the goo monster who fires goo and sticks you to the floor. And then all the people in the game shout,
goo, goo, goo,
goo.
Oh, God. Awful. Oh, they're not very good, the enemies. They're really not. And that brings me on to the gunplay, which is even worse than the enemies. The gunplay has no feel to it at all when you're running around the levels. There's only three guns, three different types. You've got a shotgun, an SMG, and it's kind of like an assault rifle. That's what you get. Now, there are special weapons as well. I think there's seven altogether, including your grenades. There's a lot of different types of grenades, which is nice. I'll come to the grenades in a second. But the gunplay, the sound all right, the guns, but the actual feel when you're firing them and the impact as they're hitting the enemy is garbage. It's just the enemy half the time don't even react to getting shot. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. It just feels very, very cheap, poor, and no feeling to it at all. When you look at other games, take Back for Blood, for example, way better. Half-Life, way better. And do you know what? We need way more guns than this. I know this is early access, but my goodness, it's £20, the early access. We should have some kind of LMG, you know? We should have better versions of the guns that we have at the minute. You have specials, which is like this big laser gun that it's all right. No problems with that. You have a turret, which is nice, which you can put down. I can't even remember the other one. It was just so kind of uninspiring that you just easily forget it. Grenades wise, that's a different ball game. You've got a load of different grenades, frag grenades, impact grenades, stasis grenades, which are essential when you're fighting the brutes, because you need to pin these things down so you can shoot them in the face, because like I said, they move so fast. You've got goo grenades, you've got vortex grenades that suck people into a black hole or something. Really nice, really good. The grenades is probably the best thing about the game, to be honest with you. It was the only really good thing that I enjoyed, apart from now and then in the levels you got some excitement. But the vast majority of the levels are pretty poor, simply because they're not well-designed levels. They're just boring. Just, for example, lots of corridors. Just corridors after corridor after corridor with little offshoot rooms that are filled with nothing. Now and then you'll find a perk machine where you can put some perks in, but they're few and far between. Then all of a sudden you'll run out of ammo, and then an ammo thing will spawn just literally in front of you, and so you run and you get all your ammo back, and then another one will spawn where there wasn't one 10 seconds ago. They just spawn at these little machines that weren't there. Like, you know, you walk along a corridor, there was no machines for ammo behind you, and then the next time you turn around, oh, there's an ammo dispenser. How did it even get there? It just teleported in. Now, there is an AI director in this that, depending on how good you're doing, will change the way the game flows. So if you're doing really well, he'll spawn more harder enemies for you. If you're doing shite, he might spawn some goodies for you. And from what I gathered, it's pretty broken. We failed twice on the end objective on one of the three final missions. Can't remember which one it was. And instead of making it easier, we were immediately confronted with two brutes pretty much 10 seconds into our third attempt at the level. It's like, hang on a minute, mate. What are you doing? Are you just f***ing sadistic now? We suck. We failed twice. You should be making it easier. No, to have two brutes and a big f***ing swarm. So, yeah, that seemed pretty broken. And as with all of these games, you're trying to make it to a safe room. And one of the best things about Left 4 Dead was getting to that safe room was usually 9 times out of 10 a frantic fight for your life. In this game, you could crawl into the safe room while smoking a cigar in 9 times out of 10 encounters. We only had one single encounter that I can think of where it was a mad rush. Sorry, two, where it was a mad rush into the safe room, and they were the best levels in the game. One of the better ones was the whole team was down. I was the only one left with a shotgun, and I was running for my life. When you get surrounded, you don't have a melee attack. You have this repulsor that you can fire 3 times before it has to recharge. And it's brilliant. It knocks the enemies back. And then you've got to open the door of the safe room, get in the safe room. And of course, they all charged in after us. And I was trying to get to the door to shut it so more of them couldn't get in. Then I had to finish off those that were in there. That was good fun. I really enjoyed that. But them moments were few and far between. And everybody that was playing the game with us got absolutely bored shitless after an hour, and I don't blame them because I was in the same boat as them. Totally bored. It was just repeat, repeat, repeat. Same weapons, same enemies, same colour schemes, same lackluster level design. And do you know, another bad thing about this game is the AI is absolute garbage. The AI that you get, if you don't fill the team with humans, you get AI players, and they, half the time they're not even facing the enemy. You know where the threat's coming from. They're just standing there scratching their fucking ass while you're getting this swarm charging. They're just awful. They heal you up when you don't really need healing. You know, when you're on like a good bit of green health, they'll come and waste a completely good health kit on you. This game's early access, I get it, but it's coming out this year in a few months' time. How the hell are they going to fix? I don't know. I was expecting Left 4 Dead in space, which could have been great. What I got was an absolute mess of a game that's not a bit fun, really. It's just boring, bad gunplay, bad enemies, bad AI, bad level design, bad colours, bad characters, no real story going on here, just boring. £20? F***ing no thanks.